beloved, and welcome to another exciting day on this devotional. This word is so precious to the Lord and to us. Yes, imitators of God. We are learning from Jesus. The Bible says we are to walk in love, even as Jesus Christ loved us, or God loved us. And Jesus modeled it for us by giving himself to God, an offering and a sacrifice. Beloved, that's what we are studying for the rest of the week. Once again, an offering is a heartfelt thank you. And a sacrifice is something I do for God, because of God, and for his sake. Beloved, that's where all the blessings are hidden away, when we do it for his sake. It's not for me. No, it's for him and the world he has sent me to. A sacrifice. Do you remember Romans chapter 12? Let me call your attention to it before we come back to our text in Ephesians. He says, I beseech you, therefore, brethren, by the mercies of God, that you present your bodies a living sacrifice, holy, acceptable to God, which is your reasonable service. Wow. He says that the offering of myself, the offering of yourself, is a reasonable service. In other words, I know that it's been interpreted that this is the least we can do, but I want to look at it literally. In other words, we will be crazy, totally unreasonable, if we don't do this. In the light of all he has done, in the light of the sacrifice Jesus made. In case you have forgotten, let me refer you to Philippians chapter 2. Go and read it. And if the Lord gives us opportunity for the rest of the week, we will touch on it so you can remember what he did for you. He says, I beseech you, brethren, watch this, by the mercies of God. Oh, beloved, this scripture so blessed me, because many times you are struggling with one thing or another, some of you with lust, some of you with bitterness, some of you with anger, some of you with pride, some of you with jealousy and envy. You're just struggling and you're praying. Beloved, come on, receive the mercy of God. God will grant you mercy to help you do it. The only thing missing is your willingness. Do you want to? He said, by the mercy of God. God knows it's tough. God knows it's difficult. But if you want to imitate God, then you have to give yourself to God. Otherwise, that grace will not manifest. That nature will not come into you. That realm of the Spirit will not open up to you. Because the beginning of any true worship is sacrifice. If you look in the Old Testament worship, the brazen altar was your first point of call. Before you can go further into the realms of God, there must be a worthy sacrifice. But there's something amazing about this. This sacrifice is just as the one Jesus did. He says it is a living sacrifice. A living sacrifice. What does that mean, beloved? You remember in the Old Testament, they brought animals and they killed them and then they offered them to the Lord. You see, that was a dead sacrifice. The animal came there unwillingly. The animal was killed unwillingly. The animal was offered unwillingly. But our own is totally different. I have to bring myself to the altar of God. I have to get on the altar, just as Isaac surrendered to his father Abraham to be tied up and up, put on that altar to be killed in offering to God. I have to get on that altar myself. I have to allow the knife of the Spirit of God and the Word of God to bring me to death on that altar. That is why it's called a living sacrifice. Nobody can force you to do it. Nobody can make you do it. Except it comes from your heart, God won't even accept it. When circumstances, you know, sometimes we make corrections because our money is messed up or we're losing something. You see, God, that doesn't please God. He will accept it and work with it. But he will still bring you to a place where you do it because you love him, not because of what you're losing or what you want to keep or any of that stuff. That doesn't have any fragrance. That is just looking out for oneself. And that is very offensive, to tell you the truth. But beloved, when you offer yourself willingly to God, yes, it's a worthy offering. It's a sacrifice. You may do it crying. You may do it hurting. You may do it weeping. But you will get the greatest breakthrough of your life. Particularly when it seems like people are getting over on you because of God's decision in your life. Don't worry. Take it. You will find yourself in a realm none of those people can ever enter in. God is faithful, and he has blessed you today. And I will see you tomorrow as we conclude this week. Amen and amen. Bye-bye.